हेलो एवरीवन, सो दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ ग्रेड फोर्थ ऑफ आईटी, कंप्यूटर एंड इट्स क्लासिफिकेशन. द टॉपिक्स दैट आर गोइंग टू बी कवर्ड इन दिस चैप्टर इज व्हाट इज कंप्यूटर, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स. द फर्स्ट इज अकॉर्डिंग टू द पर्पज एंड सेकेंड इज अकॉर्डिंग टू द साइज. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज व्हाट इज कंप्यूटर. Now you are very much familiar with this word computer, because nowadays you are using this word computers here and there, and you are also having computers at your home. So a computer is an electronic machine that takes instruction from us and gives us the result after processing on them. So basically it works on the user input, do some mechanism or process on that, and then it gives us the information or the product as a output. Now, computer classification. Computer is classified on two types. First is according to the purpose, and second is according to the size. So let's begin with the first topic, that is according to the purpose. Now you can see this chart, okay, where computer is classified into two, that is according to purpose and according to the size. In according to purpose, there are three things. First is analog, digital and hybrid. And according to the size, there are five types of computers, that is supercomputer, mainframe computer, server, microcomputer and mobile device. So we'll begin with according to the purpose. Yeah, here we go. According to purpose, computers are divided into three types: analog computer, digital and hybrid. Now we will study analog computer. An analog computer takes different input and gives as approximate result. The meaning of approximate means it is not 100%, it is 99.99% result after comparison. It works on the principle of analogous data. The examples of analog computers are clinical thermometer, voltmeter, speedometer, fuel gauge, scale machine. Now if I talk regarding thermometer, you very well know that when we are having fever, doctor puts the thermometer, okay, in our mouth for just 2 minutes, because to get an accurate reading, 2 minutes are enough, because our body temperature will going up and coming down. It is not constant, it may rise, it may decrease. So in these analog computers, we are not getting the exact result, we are getting some approximate result, because it is work on the principle of analogous data. In the speedometer, same, sometimes our speed is 50 km/h, sometimes it is 60 km/h, sometimes it is 10 km/h. So there is very much variations in the speedometers are also there. So I hope you understand the first topic, that is analog computer. Now moving to the next point, that is digital computer. Now you are very much familiar with this word, that is digital, because nowadays each and everything is digital. Computers are digitals, laptops are digitals, malls are digitals, each and everything are digital. We can see now and then digital payment is also there, our digital India movement is also there. So a digital computer works on the principle of binary mathematics. Now binary means 0 and 1 number. In binary, all the calculations are represented as 0 and 1. Computer understand only the binary language. Whatever we are writing, if you are typing a letter A, it is converted into binary language in form of 0s and 1. And this language is understood by computer, and computer works on that language and gives us output as a A. So examples of digital computer are microcomputer, laptop computer, digital wristwatch, calculators. These all are the examples of a digital computers. Nowadays we are having the digital watch also, like Fitbit. So these are the few examples which are working on digital computer. Now we are moving for the last topic, that is hybrid computer. The word hybrid means combination of two or more things. So here it is mentioned, hybrid computers are combination of both analog and digital computer. A hybrid computer system offers a cost effective method that is used to perform complex simulations. Example of hybrid computer is ECG machine that we can see in the hospital, which is used to measure the heartbeat of the patient. We can see that this machine in the hospitals. So, hybrid computer is nothing but the combination of both analog and digital computer. So, I hope you understand all the 3 points. Now, we are moving to the next classification, that is according to the size. And in that, first is supercomputer. Supercomputer is working as like a name. It is super. Supercomputer is the biggest and the most powerful computer. It is very expensive in cost, and it can perform a trillion of instruction per second. It is mentioned here in the speed, they can process 1 trillion instruction per second. As it is very expensive and the size is very big. Yes, here mentioned in the size, it is the biggest computer and it is as big as a size of a room. Now, where the supercomputers are used? Supercomputers are used in weather forecasting, nuclear power station, military simulation, research laboratories, okay, and animation movies. Now, if I take the example of weather forecasting. Weather forecasting, they are giving us the information regarding the current weather. Weather can change within a minute. So, if we are not getting a proper information within few seconds, then it will damage us. So, if we are giving the information that on tomorrow, if there will be a heavy rainfall, and this information if we get after few days, then what will happen? Definitely, the damage will be done to us. So, such industries or such places where the work is very much important and the information should be proper and at the speed. So, at such places, supercomputers are being used. Now, moving to the next, that is mainframe computer. Now, this mainframe computer, let's see the description of mainframe computer. Mainframe computer is also very large and powerful, but it is less powerful than the supercomputer and it is less expensive than the supercomputer. It is having a capacity, okay, to host a multiple operating system same time. Mainframe computers was the first developed by the IBM. Now, if you talk about the size, it is normally the size of the closest. Means at half of the room, we can consider that half of the room is occupied by this mainframe computer. If you have seen the movie Ravan and Robot, in that you will able to see that mainframe computers are being used for gaming because they are hosting the games in Ravan, and at a time they are working on the many users. So, location, it is mostly found in the large business houses or the government centers. Speed, it can process also a million instruction per second, and that is also a huge speed because at a time they have to work with many users. If you talk about government centers, there are many government centers, and to work with them, this is the speed we require to work same time with the same users or the different users. Uses, it is mostly used for scientific research and doing bulk mathematical operation. Moving to the next point, server. Now, I hope you have heard this word now and then. Our telecommunication department or our internet service provider always say us, server is down. Even our TV connection is also says that server is down, we don't have server. Okay, like this we are getting. Then what is the meaning of server? A server is nothing but a main system which control the other system. So let's see the description. Server is a lifeblood of any network. It is like a lifeblood of a network. If server is been shut down, then each and every system will be shut down. It controls the access of hardware, software and other resource on a network and provide a centralized storage area for the program data and the information. So with the server, if any of the computer is attached, then whatever the data is been stored, that will be stored in the server, not on particular system. So this is the working of server. Server is having each and every data of each and every computers. If your client computers or the computers that is been attached with the server, if they are shut down, it doesn't mean that server is shut down. If your server is shut down, then each and every computers will be get shut down. Location, if you talk about location, it is mostly found in office, banks and schools. Speed of server is increasing day by day. Yes, that's a fact, because nowadays we want high storage capacity and high speed to increase the smoothness of the work. Uses, server supports from 2 to several thousand connected computers at the same time. If in a company, if there are 50 computers are working and there is one server, so server supports that each and every system should work properly, they should get the internet connection, hardware should work properly, the software should work properly. This is the main task of the server. After that, microcomputer. Now this is very easy topic, microcomputer, because on the screen which you are using right now, that is microcomputer, or I can say that is your desktop computer, or I can say that is your personal computer, which is having keyboard, mouse, one screen. If you are having printer, then if you are having microphone. Okay, so let's go with the description. A microcomputer is often called as a personal computer, where one person can sit and access it. It is the smallest of all computer. The most important part of microcomputer is microprocessor. It is having a small processor inside a CPU which do the complex level programming or complex level working in the CPU to run your whole system. Also called it as a brain. Peripherals such as keyboard, mouse, as I said that there are many parts or peripheral devices of computer, that is mouse, keyboard, XYZ. Then size, it is small, that can be kept on the table. Location, it is mostly found in offices, homes and schools for personal use. Speed is also increasing day by day. As you can see, before 2 years or before 1 years or before 6 months, we were using phones that is having 1 GB RAM, 2 GB RAM, and nowadays you can see that we can use nowadays the speed of RAM is increasing. Now it is 4 GB RAM, 5 GB RAM, 6 GB RAM. Same it is there for the computers. Earlier the computers were using 2 GB RAM, 3 GB RAM, but nowadays the configuration are increasing day by day. They are giving much more storage capacity, like 1 TB. They are giving a speed of 6 GB RAM, 7 GB RAM, 8 GB RAM, 10 GB RAM, like that. Now uses, it is used to create documents, as nowadays you are using it for your doing of your daily work, like painting, like working on Excel, working on Words, looking on PDF, net surfing, doing your daily works of school assignments or your office's work. So this was the description of microcomputer. Desktop computer is also a type of microcomputer. Now let's move ahead. First is desktop computer. There is not much more difference between a desktop computer and a microcomputer. Desktop computer is also the same as the microcomputer. So we'll just go through with the content. A desktop computer is a computer made of use on a desk. It is kept on desk, so that's why it is said as a desktop computer. It is used as school, homes and offices. It is designed such that the system unit, input device, output device and all other device fit entirely on a table. Now the favorite device of yours, that is mobile device. You know each and everything regarding this device. Is it is fitted in our palm. A mobile device is used to store data on memory inside it or on small storage media such as memory card. Size is small, that can be carried in a bag or on a pocket. Location, mostly it is found everywhere. Speed, increasing day by day. Uses, it can use for the personal it can be used for the personal reasons, okay, for exchanging information. Now few are the topics that we will look here, like laptop computer, tablet PC, smartphone, ebook reader, smartwatch, digital camera and game console are also type of mobile device. So further it has been categorized, mobile devices are further categorized into these 6 types. So laptop computers, many of the users, you are accessing your father or your mother laptop for Google Classroom, So here we go. Laptop computer is also called as a notebook because it is just looking like a notebook. We open it, we close it. It is a small and lightweight computer that can be easily carried, and it is also having built-in keyboard, touchpad, that is mouse, and display screen. Tablet PC. I hope you are having the tablet PCs at your home. It is slightly bigger in size in comparison of your nowadays smartphone. Okay, so tablet PC is also a special type of portable computer which has touch screen. You can use it as a tablet by touching the screen everywhere or your finger or with a digital pen. Nowadays latest tablet resemble phones, smartphones, and only difference is that they are just larger than the smartphones. So we can say that we can utilize the tablet PC also as a smartphone. Now the favorite of yours, smartphone. It is called as a smartphone because we are having the facility of internet in the phone. So this makes the phone as a smartphone. In addition to the basic phone facilities, it allows you to send and receive email messages and access to the internet. It is having many features that you can have the music, you can have a video, you can play games, you can click pictures. Many are the features of the smartphone. E-book reader. An e-book reader is an electronic book reader, is an handheld device that is used for primarily for reading purpose. For especially for the reading purpose, we are also having a digital gadget that is called as a e-book reader, inside which many books are being kept. And if those books you want the fresh new books, you can just access the with the internet, because internet facility is also provided into the e-book reader. So whatever you want the books to read, it is already there and it won't be deleted. So e-books is the electronic version of the printed books. Most e-book readers have a touch screen and also internet enabled. Smartwatch. A smartwatch is a mobile device with a touchscreen display designed to be worn on the wrist. Nowadays you are using Fitbit to calculate the calories, to calculate the steps, to know who is sending you the WhatsApp message, to check the notification, to check the calls. So this is another device, that is smartwatch, in which all the features of phones are there, and which and more features are there. Like you can see, it is given some of the examples, notification like message, emails, calls, and social networks. Now moving to the next topic, digital camera. Now this word is not also new for you, because you are using the CyberShot or Nikon camera. A digital camera is a mobile device that allows user to take pictures and store photograph image digitally. Instead of the traditional film, after taking the photograph, you can download a copy of the image and from the digital camera to the hard disk of the computer. You can click the photograph and instantly you can just remove the memory card from the digital camera and you can attach it with the computer, and then you can download it in your hard disk, or you can just access it through the phone also. So now the last topic is gaming console. A game console is a mobile computing device designed for specially for those who are lover of the games. It can be a single player or it can be a multiple player. You can see some of the examples are given, like Microsoft Xbox 360, Nintendo Wii, Sony PlayStation 4. Sony PlayStation 4 is very much popular nowadays. So these are the few gaming consoles are also there in the digital world. So I hope you understood all these categories in the mobile devices. So again, we will do the summary that in this chapter what we have understood. So let's begin with the first topic, that what was the computer. You know, computer is nothing but an electronic machine which is having keyboard, mouse, CPU, monitor. Then we have studied the classification of computer. So now it is on the classification. It is having two topics, that is according to purpose and according to size. According to purpose, we are having analog computer, digital computer, hybrid computer, supercomputer. According to the main, according to size, if we talk, we can go for a supercomputer, mainframe computer, server, microcomputer, mobile device. Then we have seen the detailed examples of according to the purpose. According to the size, we have seen the supercomputer, mainframe computer. We have seen the description, size, location, speed. then we have went for server, then microcomputer, and then we have reached to the end, that was the mobile device and the type of mobile devices that we are using nowadays. So I hope you understand what is there in the first chapter, that is classification of computers, and I hope you will understood whatever the topics I had covered. So this was the end of the first chapter. You have to complete your exercise. So till then, we will meet soon. Till then, you have to just say be safe at your home. So we will meet soon. Bye bye. Thank you, and have a good day.